at the Belt and Road Summit 2018, where we're with Manuel Pangilinan. He's the chairman of one of the Philippines' largest conglomerates. Thanks very much indeed, Manny, for joining us. And now really looking at the Belt and Road Initiative, what would you see as what you'd call the perfect success story for the Belt and Road in the Philippines?
Well, if we could replicate portions of what so far have been accomplished in the Belt and Road Initiative, I think that would be a resounding success. And if that's done with the help of China, that will really contribute to the tremendous success factor of the BRI in the Philippines.
So everything is really about collaboration. Do you see that actually as an ongoing thing right now and into the future?
Well, with the advent of the Duterte government, relations with China have improved a lot. No? President has been more open to Chinese assistance, support, and I think the government, through the President of China, President Xi Jinping, have pledged quite a tidy sum of money for support to the infrastructure initiatives of the Duterte government.
Now, you're the chairman of one of the Philippines' largest conglomerates. So that how do you see your own group actually coming to bear with the Belt and Road? Is it going to be one item or another? In other words, will it be infrastructure and, say, property or other things as well?
Mainly infrastructure. We're the largest, amongst others, infrastructure group in the Philippines. And from one perspective, contracting would be a great opportunity to work with Chinese contractors. And indeed, we've been approached by a number of Chinese mainland contractors to do the civil works for our many projects on tollways, bridges, and even water systems. No? The other would be the form of financial assistance or financial help to the many projects that we're undertaking in infrastructure. The third would be technical support on ICT, where China is well advanced in technology.
Now, you're very familiar with Hong Kong, having been here backwards and forwards for many, many years. Indeed, you developed a large company here that's on the Hong Kong stock market. But would you say that Hong Kong is really the hub for things like risk analysis? That's sort of a question that you would bring up in the Belt and Road.
It can be the hub not only for China itself, but for the countries that the Belt and Road Initiative will cover, no? Central Asia and even Eastern Europe, and of course, Europe proper itself. No? As you know, the road and the rail will connect all the way to Hamburg and other ports in Germany and France, and even I saw a terminus in Madrid itself. So it could open up markets that are heretofore been quite difficult for ASEAN countries to access. No?
So you're here at the Belt and Road Summit 2018. What's your impressions of the summit?
It brings together quite a number of the largest companies, not only in Hong Kong, but China. Like in our panel, we had the significant conglomerate from Indonesia, Madame Shinda, then of course, Geely, and then the construction company of China, of course, MTR here. No? So I was surprised at the extent of the coverage, country coverage, that these four individuals have. You know, it's an honor to be part of the panel with them.